Gitanjali's story just has marvel in its heart. We talk about our heroes in the way that they look outside their window and help the world. Gitanjali is a perfect example of that because she sees this news report about the water crisis in Flint, and she uses that as inspiration to create something that will help future towns discover when they have contaminated water.
There's also something so simplistic about the way that she builds her devices too. Like, it really reminds me of Moon Girl, because Moon Girl is just this young...
She just uses what she has.
Uses what she has around her, and she builds these, like, this really cool tech, and is also super positive, and is like, I can fix all of the problems.
And where Moon Girl has Devil Dinosaur, Gitanjali has a brother.
Yes.
Yeah, all of her brothers, so cute.
Well, that's what's fascinating about Gitanjali, is the fact that she doesn't just stop there, right? She sees other problems, and she's like, well, I'm gonna try to fix that. And it's,
yeah.
And it's all through science. It's all through science, which of course is very reminiscent of you know, one of the biggest Marvel heroes ever, which is Tony Stark. Right?
Not familiar with him?
Let me tell you the story about Tony Stark.
My favorite thing about Gitanjali is that she's also trying to inspire other female scientists.
Yes.
Yeah, we have one of our heroes, Wasp, Nadia Van Dyne. She has a group of female scientists, the Agents of GRL, that she brings together.
Cool
she's name. Like, you know, we need to encourage girls to do science, you know? And so she just brings all the best minds she can find together to help solve problems.
I think she fits in perfectly with the Marvel Universe, and I think she's gonna be a great member of the Hero Project.